Exclusive.
As you can see, I've already got it all glued down on my cap, and I really should like sit and let it dry a little bit more, but this cap is hot and I'm ready to take it off. So what I'm going to go ahead and do, I hear my mouth, is I'm going to cut this little horseshoe area out here. And then what I'm going to do after that is I'm going to sew small wig clips here. I'm also going to put two larger ones back here in the back. And I'm going to sew those in. So, let me go ahead and cut this part.
They wouldn't have had in Lubbock, Texas, or in Austin, Texas, or in College Station, Texas. Well, maybe you had a shot to get away with your crimes.
Understand if the Times Herald or the Morning News were going to go investigate A&M or Texas or Tech or Baylor, they would have to leave their area.
SMU, they're the one school in the Southwest Conference based in Dallas, so they're right under our nose.
Shoot, you could have investigated SMU with a bicycle.
When the local media turns its guns on you, you're finished.
It did seem to me that by 1983, things had kind of come to a head.
There's no question, that's when the calls started coming.
If you're going to be a dirty program, you better good at it. You better understand that the group handling the dirtiness has to be small, and it has to be committed, and it doesn't go out and chirp at bars.
It was a sick atmosphere surrounding SMU football.
February or so of 1983, when I got handed the SMU file, I think there were 13 reports from institutions outside and inside the Southwest Conference.
They were getting phone calls from the other schools saying, you got to come down here and investigate these people.
SMU was the new fastest gun in the West, but it wasn't a traditional power.
Then, when SMU expanded its national recruiting and started going to Michigan, started going to Pennsylvania, those schools started calling, saying, you know, SMU.
Hey, YouTube, I'm back. As you can see, I finished making the quick weave system, and what I've done is installed it, and I took some hair out up here, which is not the best job, but I'm putting it in right now for the purpose of cutting it into a style. And the style that I'm going for is a angled bob, and I took these two pieces out because this is going to be the longer pieces, and then I'm going to cut the back. And as you can see, I've already put this in a ponytail. And the technique that I'm using, I got it from Into Her. That's her channel. I love her channel. She has some really good detailed videos on cutting bobs. So this is where I got this technique from, and I've used this technique all the time. And what I do is I put the hair in a ponytail, and I want the bob to be longer than normal, so that's why the ponytail is lower. And what I'm going to do is actually cut underneath the rubber band and cut up like so. I don't know if I'm going to be able to, well, I probably cut down, but I really want to cut up, but it's easier for me to cut up. Let me redo my ponytail. It's easier for me to cut down, actually. So. Maybe I can do it from the side. Okay. Here we go. Took a long time. Okay, I know it probably looks crazy back there because my cutting is a little bit crazy, but let me turn around and show it to you. But I definitely am going to clean it up as soon as I find my other mirror. So this is what it looks like right now. I'm gonna go ahead and clean the back up, and then I will be back. Hey YouTube, I am finished. I went ahead and cut it, which I showed some of that, and I also put layers in it. What I use to put layers in it is my simple razor comb that you can get from a local beauty supply store for like $3. And that's what I did, and I decided to go ahead and curl it so I could get an idea of the style that I want to go for, and this is exactly it. And what I did to help secure the quick weave system better is I put a braid here, and I also put a braid like right here. And when I put the wig clips in, I clipped them in there, and that actually makes it more secure. And I did put 2 wig clips at the back, and I went ahead and bumped it with my Andi's flat iron. And I curled this part out. I don't know when, but eventually I'll do a video on me curling it so I can show you guys actually how I use my flat iron. So this is pretty much it, the end result. It's actually, let's see what time it is. Wow, it's already like 12 o'clock. So I'll probably try to upload this for you guys as soon as possible. But this is the end result, and I actually love it. And the fact that I'm going to be able to take this off and moisture my hair on a daily basis is going to be very beneficial for me, especially since I'm transitioning. So here it is. Here's the back. It may look a little crazy because I just bumped it and this side is longer than this side, and this up here is my real hair. So I will also have pictures at the end for you guys, and I hope you guys like. Please feel free to ask me any questions about my hairstyle. And thank you guys for watching. Y'all have a great night. Good night.